As you know, I love using off-meta cards and creating off-meta decks. They not only change up your gameplay, but they can also catch your opponents off guard and give you the surprise factor in matches. In addition to that, they're honestly just very fun to use overall, as many of these cards have a unique mechanic not seen anywhere else in the game. Hey guys, it's Andre here, and today I'm going to be going over 5 off-meta cards that work really well in the current meta. Now, there are definitely more than these 5, but these 5 cards are honestly my favorites. All these cards do not have a high use rate or win rate, but definitely can do really, really well. So, without further ado, let's get right into the list. Number 1, Giant Skeleton. As many people would say, Giant Skeleton is one of the most underrated cards in the game. Obviously, with its massive death bomb, it is basically a walking positive elixir trade. Killing both ground and air units, it's the ultimate lane clogger. To use him, mainly play him reactively, say for example, after your opponent plays a giant in the back. They can't really do anything because, you know, once that bomb blows, everything's dead. Also, getting that massive explosion to your opponent's tower is just one of the most satisfying moments ever in the game. Number 2, Cannon Cart. Cannon Cart is another really unique card. It turns from a troop into a building. In addition, it moves quite fast as well, so players may find it hard to place something down in time to distract the cart before it locks onto the tower, and boy, if that cart locks on, that's gonna be a lot of damage. Once again, this card does really well on defense and is mainly a card you want to use as a counter push, or you can just leave it alone as your opponent has to respond something to it. Plus, even if the cart dies, you still got the cannon, which outputs a ton of damage and does really well at distracting tanks. Number 3, Lightning. This one is not as off-meta as some of the others, but Lightning still has a relatively low use rate despite its super high versatility. With cards such as Rascals, Wizards, and 3 Musketeers running around, Lightning can give you so much value, especially with its massive range. Lightning goes well with a ton of archetypes, Beatdown, Lavaloon, Hog, and it's definitely a super satisfying card to use. I mean, those 3 bolts just instantly vaporize troops. How cool is that? Also, Lightning can be used as a surprise card. Hold your Lightning until the very end and use it with that Hog to surprise your opponent and take the game. Number 4, Skeleton Barrel. This is one of those cards that has sort of fallen off the meta. Skeleton Barrel with its skeletons does really well in bait decks. Since it almost always requires a spell to take out, pair it with a ton of swarm cards and you can easily overwhelm all of your opponents. Just send it in with a miner, and if they don't defend the barrel correctly, that's going to be a ton of damage on the tower. However, Skeleton Barrel not only has deadly offensive capabilities, it also has a purpose on defense as well. Use it to distract units and to utilize the death damage to take out minions, goblins, and a ton of other units. Plus, the skeletons that spawn can also do very well as a distraction. Number 5, Freeze. Freeze is probably one of the best surprise cards in the game. Sure, other cards such as Ice Wizard and Giant Snowball slow units, but Freeze completely stops them for 4 or even 5 entire seconds. Similar to Lightning, you can save the spell until the very end to finish off a match. Just don't use that card the entire match and pull it out at the end to completely catch your opponent off guard. Also, in very desperate situations, Freeze can also be used to just stall out the final few seconds of the game. This card mainly works well with Hog and Graveyard, but it has been seen in many other archetypes as well, so it definitely has its many uses. So there we go, 5 of my favorite off-meta cards I like to use when creating a fun off-meta deck. I really enjoy playing all 5 of these cards, and they can really be a pain for your opponents to deal with. In addition, having the surprise factor in a battle can give you a massive advantage, such as saving Lightning and Freeze until the very end and absolutely dominating with them. I hope you guys give some of these cards a try, and if you have any cool decks using these cards, be sure to leave them in the comment section below. But unfortunately guys, that is all the time for today. If you enjoyed, please leave a like down below as well as a subscription to my channel. And as always, this is Little Duray, and I'm signing off. See you guys next time.